How are you feeling, Mum?
Son and Holy Spirit. Amen. God is love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. It's wonderful that we're here, finally, to be together with both Christopher and Tracy for this very special moment in their life together, and of course the life of their families as well. Let us pray. Almighty God, all grace comes from you, and you alone are the source of life and love. Send your Holy Spirit and pour into our hearts that most excellent gift of love, that we may worship you now with thankful hearts and serve you always with willing minds, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
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 I now have to read this long paragraph which explains the Christian understanding of marriage. So bear with me. In the presence of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we have come together to witness the marriage of Christopher and Tracy, to pray for God's blessing on them, to share their joy, and to celebrate their love. Marriage is a gift of God in creation, through which husband and wife may know the grace of God. It is given that as man and woman grow together in love and trust, they shall be united with one another in heart, body, and mind, just as Christ is united with his bride, the Church. The gift of marriage brings husband and wife together in the delights and tenderness of bodily union and joyful commitment to the end of their lives. It is given as the foundation of family life, in which children are nurtured, and in which each member of the family, in good times and in bad, finds strength, companionship and comfort, and grow to maturity in love. Marriage is a way of life made holy by God and blessed by the presence of Jesus with those celebrating a wedding at Cana in Galilee. Marriage is a sign of unity and loyalty which all should uphold and honour. It enriches society and strengthens community. No one should enter into it lightly or selfishly, but reverently and responsibly in the sight of Almighty God. Christopher and Tracy are now to enter this way of life. They will each give their consent to the other and make solemn vows, and in token of this they will each give and receive a ring. We pray with them that the Holy Spirit will guide and strengthen them, that they may fulfill God's purposes for the whole of their earthly life together. First, I am required to ask anyone present who knows a reason why these persons may not lawfully marry to declare it now. That's always a reason. This is now your question. Tracy and Christopher, the vows that you are about to be, who is judge of all and knows all the secrets of our hearts. Therefore, if either of you knows a reason why you may not lawfully marry, you must declare it now.
No reason.
Good. Now, the answer to this question is, I will. Okay? As long as you get that right. Christopher, will you take Tracy to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honour and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Tracy, same answer. Tracy, will you take Christopher to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Friends and family, the next question is for you. The answer is, we will, I hope. Will you, the families of Christopher and Tracy, support and uphold them in their marriage now and in the years to come?
We will.
Fantastic. Let us pray. God our Father, from the beginning you have blessed creation with abundant life. Pour out your blessing upon Christopher and Tracy, that they may be joined in mutual love and companionship, in holiness and commitment to each other. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, for ever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
I do.
Fantastic. You're already holding hands, but I've got to say this line anyway. Christopher and Tracy, I now invite you to join hands and to make your vows in the presence of God and his people. It's Tracy Jane, isn't it? Don't look at me, look at Tracy. But listen to me. I, Christopher, take you, Tracy Jane. Don't say that. I, Christopher.
Oh, I, Christopher.
Take you,
Tracy Jane.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death
us do part. According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God.
In the presence of God.
I make this vow.
I make this vow.
Okay, Tracy, you now say after me. I, Tracy Jane, take you, Christopher.
I, Tracy Jane, take you, Christopher.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy will.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God.
In the presence of God.
I make this vow.
I make this vow.
Matthew, could I have the rings, please? On my book. Wonderful. Thank you very much, Matthew. Ask God's blessing on these rings that they can be a sign of your unending love. Heavenly Father, by your blessing, let these rings be to Christopher and Tracy a symbol of unending love and faithfulness, to remind them of the vow and covenant which they have made this day through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Now, which one is your ring, Tracy? Okay. Do you want to push that onto Tracy's ring finger?
No, I have to show it.
Okay, well, just hold your hand like that. Can you stay hold that? Are you okay to do that?
Yeah.
And again, say after me. Tracy, I give you this ring.
Tracy, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honour you.
With my body, I honour you.
All that I am.
All that I am.
I give to you.
I give to you.
And all that I have,
and all that I have,
I share with you.
I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Just push them away. Right. Okay. Let me take Christopher's ring. And you're going to push the punches and like that. And just hold it there and say after me, Christopher, I give you this ring.
Christopher, I give you this ring
as a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honour you.
With my body, I honour you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Okay, push your way on. Keep hands. A short reading from the Bible. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. And now faith, hope, and love abide. These three, and the greatest of these, is love. Let us pray. Faithful God, holy and eternal, source of life and spring of love, we thank and praise you for bringing Christopher and Tracy to this day, and we pray for them now. May their marriage be life-giving and lifelong, enriched by your presence and strengthened by your grace, May they bring comfort and confidence to each other in faithfulness and trust. And may they nurture their family with devotion. And may their family nurture them in love, that they may grow together as a single unit in body, mind, and spirit, and come at last to the end of their lives with hearts content and in joyful anticipation of heaven. And if you know the words to the Our Father, please join in with me. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Now, we'll bring hands together, like that. Holding hands like that. Okay, I'm going to wrap my stool around here. In the presence of God, and before this wonderful congregation, Christopher and Tracy have given their consent and have made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully grant you the riches of his grace, that you may please him both in body and soul, and living together in faith and love, may receive the blessing of eternal life. Amen.
Amen.
Now you may applaud. What I have to do, however, we've got to sign the marriage document, so before we throw all the confetti, which I know you're just dying to do, can I sign the marriage document, get all that out the way, and then we can pop the bubbly and do all those things that you want to do. Is that all right?
Yeah.
So I need, someone's going to help. And now I'm going to reach a question, but Tracy, can you go first, perhaps? Can you sign there? Just a bit. Can you make it? We need you to do is to put your name in rock capitals and sign it all next to it, and then I can put in your name.
So Ashley,
and then Ashley will do it. So you put your name on the sign. Basically, you've got to be able to read it.
Coming for you, I'd give my life for you.
gave me a shoulder when I needed it. You showed me love when I wasn't feeling it. You helped me fight when I was giving in. And you made me laugh when I was losing it. 'Cause you are the reason why I'm still hanging on. 'Cause you are the reason why my head is still above water. And if I could, I'd get you the moon and give it to you. And if death was coming